An auto shop doesn't share much in common with a biomedical engineering lab at the U of M. But to understand the cancer research happening here, let's start by looking at a roadmap.
There are certain architectures or pathways in tumors, much like a highway network, that cancer cells utilize to move around and ultimately leave the tumor and spread throughout the body.
To stop the spread, Paolo Provenzano and his colleagues first had to check under the hood to find out what made the cancer cells go.
We thought for sure that it would be the cells exert forces to pull themselves along, much like the rubber meets the road for a car. And we thought if we targeted and broke that engine, the cells would stop. Turns out when we did that, that's where they got sneaky and they switched to another mechanism of doing it.
You see, even without an engine, Paolo says the cells still find a way to coast down the highway.
You could think of it maybe like a sled being pulled versus a sled sliding on its own.
So the team got to work targeting both the cell's engine and navigation.
So we were able to stop the cells in their tracks and stop them from sensing these highways. In essence, we break their GPS.
The discovery is already getting attention across the scientific community for its potential in the fight against breast and pancreatic cancers. And it's powered in part by the Randy Shaver Cancer Research and Community Fund, which has provided tens of thousands of dollars to Paolo and his team in recent years. And tonight, he made a request to renew that funding in hopes of taking their research down the next road.
So for us, it's a matter of taking technologies and taking therapies to the next level and the next direction, and starting to move them from the bench in towards a therapeutic and a clinical setting. It's time to put your foot on the pedal instead of pull it off.
It will likely be a couple of years before this research begins to make its way into clinical trials, which also take extensive time and money. That's why he says it's so critical to have the support of Randy's Cancer Research Fund. And Julie, we found out tonight that they're going to be making those decisions late into tonight. They'll learn in the coming days whether or not they'll get that renewed funding.
Well, I know that tonight, that's where Randy is, of course, is hearing these proposals and they're deciding who gets the money. They're giving away nearly $860,000 tonight.
Just so impressive. Incredible. And you see what it does.
Yes, it's amazing. Thank you, Kent.